Today, digital privacy is considered non-negotiable. Encryption technology is embedded into the apps we use and websites we visit, all thanks to open source cryptography. Once, however, it was considered a superpower that shouldn't be put into the hands of anyone. A similar sentiment you hear about artificial intelligence today.
How rude!
A digital invisibility cloak for cyberspace was a grave concern for law enforcement, who feared a brave new world of super fast and impossible to intercept criminal communications. Encryption was once classed as a munition and subject to export controls. Then as consumer demand grew thanks to the rise of personal computers, there were moves to outlaw its use altogether. In 1991, then-Senator Joe Biden tried to make encrypting messages illegal. And after his election, President Clinton made similar attempts. Rather than allowing encryption technology to proliferate, regulators doubled down. In 1991, Joe Biden introduced two bills containing anti-encryption language to prevent private emails, the Comprehensive Counterterrorism Act and the Violent Crime Control Act. This regulatory push galvanized technologists like Phil Zimmerman, who finished and released his open source encryption project, Pretty Good Privacy, or PGP, in response. PGP rapidly gained traction across the early internet, crossing international borders and making it increasingly challenging to regulate. Zimmerman became the target of a grand jury investigation due to his work. At the same time, the Clinton administration intensified efforts by advocating for the NSA's Clipper chip, a device intended to grant the government access to all encrypted communications. The ultimate aim of this project, led by Vice President Al Gore, was to mandate the use of this chip. After years of back and forth, the US government ultimately decided not to prosecute Zimmerman, and the Clipper chip project was officially abandoned. However, export restrictions on encryption continued to stifle the US software industry until they were eventually eased in 1999. Even though strong encryption is a key component of our everyday lives, from secure email and texting to online shopping and banking, this debate is far from settled. Even now, security concerns are frequently invoked to question encryption and new technologies like AI.
These algorithms, they are the digital equivalent of AR-15. I'm serious.
The hard-won lessons of the 1990s, when we came close to trading privacy and freedom for the promise of safety, appear to be forgotten in today's conversations about technology.